Good evening. For the first time in the state's history, Telstra has had to step in to help answer emergency calls. A 32% increase in demand in 24 hours, the fourth highest volume in the recorded history of the Queensland Ambulance Service. And it left patients and paramedics stuck in queues for hours.
Paramedics under pressure and overstretched.
The scenes that we witnessed throughout the southeast yesterday shouldn't be part of a modern Queensland health system.
The state opposition has long claimed the health system is at breaking point. Scenes like this yesterday added fuel to the fire.
Patients are waiting up to 8 hours at the end of an ambulance ramp. That's an entire shift.
At the peak of the Omicron wave in January, the state recorded its highest ever 000 call volume. Demand yesterday wasn't far behind, with almost 4,000 calls for QAS help. Of those, more than 1,500 were code 1 emergencies, the 24-hour total, the fourth highest ever seen in Queensland.
However, what we saw yesterday was historic.
But why isn't clear, according to the Health Minister.
Look, I don't know any hospital system in the country that can prepare for a 30 to 40% increase on a single given day.
We would rather a more timely response, but when the chips are down, we'll always prioritise those highest emergencies.
The health system was so stretched yesterday, for the first time ever in Queensland, Telstra initiated a pre-recorded message advising callers there was such high demand, and if it wasn't an emergency, they should phone 13 Health instead. The state's COVID numbers are reducing, but the second wave has taken its toll. The state still recorded close to 8,000 cases today.
So we know that with those COVID numbers in our hospitals, as well as our staff who are isolating or quarantining, that is putting pressure on the system.
And it appears there's no valve to release it yet. Jacob Chigo for 10 News First.